Okay, so welcome to Materia Medica series day 19, and you are all welcome for today's talk. It was a very special day. Just like every day, we are going to start with a talk where I'm going to share a case and I'm going to ask you your suggestions for a remedy. The case for today, we are talking about a very, very interesting case. I learned a lot from this case and I'm going to share something very interesting, and let us see. So this is a case of chronic eczema, a 50-year-old lady, and very interestingly, this lady has been to at least 3-4 different homeopaths, and she has been to many, many doctors. She has been to many allopathic doctors, many Ayurvedic doctors, many Unani medicines. She has been to a lot of doctors, but she has been to very, very high profile doctors in homeopathy. And then she has come to see me, and I saw her about 4 years back, 3-4 years back. And she was given the remedy Lachesis, okay, and Calcarea Carb by a different homeopaths. So I brought a little bit of a gist of the case, and I'm going to share with you what I thought about it. My friend Faiza has joined. Hello, Faiza. So this is a case of chronic eczema of the feet. And the thing about the feet is the eczema with thick eruptions, bad eruptions, lot of scales, and the scales and the thick eruptions, especially on the leg, on the feet, and intolerable type of itching all over the feet. She can't even wear her sandals because of her very, very bad eczema. And I ask her, what is the effect of this problem on you? And she laughs. She really laughs. She said, kya bol rahe hain aap log? I think you only can cure me. And she suddenly says out of nowhere that, doctor, I feel you will cure me. Let's see what homeopathy can do. And there is a lot of animation in the way she talks as well. Then I ask her, can you tell me about yourself? Because her case taking is very different, because her way of talking is very, very strange. She says, doctor, I have met many doctors, more than 50 different doctors, but no one has helped me. But I am sure homeopathy will help, and I'm sure you will help. I don't know about other homeopaths. I know you will cure me. And then she again starts laughing. And this was like, you know, 3-4 years back. And I was really thinking, kya chal raha hai? What should I do? And the thing about her is I ask her, okay, tell me about yourself. And then she tells her entire life story. She talks about how she gets up in the morning at 6 o'clock, and then she cooks the food, and then she goes to the bathroom, she cleans the house, and the whole dincharya, the whole timetable of the house, she keeps on talking. This goes on for next half an hour. And then I ask her, can you tell me about yourself, about your basic nature? Again, she keeps talking. And then she speaks about how she met her husband and how it was an arranged marriage and how things were very, very difficult for her. But she says, I'm very happy-go-lucky. Main apni favorite hoon. I'm very, very happy. I keep everyone happy. And I have very settled life. Then she talks about her fears. And the fears are especially when anything suddenly comes in front of her. When anything suddenly comes in front of her, she gets very scared. And she's very scared of darkness. Very scared of being alone. Very, very scared of insecurity. She feels very insecure about everything. Dreams. Then I ask her, can you tell me any dreams? And she says, many scary dreams. Especially, I get dreams which I don't remember, but I know that I get scared. I know 100% that I get scared. What are the things you enjoy doing? She says, I love cooking. Khana banana bahut pasand hai. And I love meeting people. I am the person who will always go and meet different people. I love social gatherings. I'm just full of life. And I just enjoy meeting people, talking, loving, enjoying life. This is me, she says. So are you all with me? This is the case. Generality, she sweats a lot. She's a very hot patient. She craves junk food, craves rice, and her sleep is very good as well. So what do you think? Some thoughts about the remedy. I'm going to tell you the case again, in short. And I want to tell you, she has taken a lot of remedies from many, many doctors. Phosphorus, Calcarea, Lachesis, almost all Polycrest remedy must have touched her once. I believe so. Nageshwar Belamokonda, Calcarea Carb. She has already taken Calcarea Carb, doctor. Okay, let me tell you again. So we are talking about this case who has taken many, many, many remedies. Chronic eczema on the feet, thick eruptions on the leg, on the feet, intolerable itching, intolerable. Can't even wear sandals. Effect of the problem on her, her thing is she takes everything very lightly. She laughs. And she's very positive about it. She says, no, I know you will cure me. I know about, no, don't know about others, but I know you will cure me. And then she says, I met more than 50 doctors and no one has cured me, but I know you will cure me. And she starts laughing. And she says, keeps talking for the next 30 minutes about her life, how she met her husband, what is her timetable, how is her children, how she's happy-go-lucky and everything. And then she talks about a lot of fears of something happening very suddenly. She's scared of anything sudden. She feels insecure when she's alone as well. Lot of dreams, and she gets scared in the dreams, typically. Lot of interest in cooking, meeting many people. She loves all kind of social gatherings, and also she is full of life and happy-go-lucky. She sweats a lot, and she's a very hot patient, craves rice, typically. That's her. So let's see the suggestion. Hardik says it's Piper. Mamta says Phagopyrum. Phagopyrum pruritus senilis. Pruritus senilis. Bhumika says Belladonna. Okay, do we have Solanus fears here? Sanket says Tarantula. Swapnali says Phosphorus.
Few suggestions from the people in GoToWebinar. Paris quadrifolia.
Okay.
Then we have Cannabis indica. Lacaninum. Sulfur. Parita Phos. Kaliayod. Lycopodium.
Okay, interesting. So I'm going to tell you something very interesting because I learned a lot from this case. Hopefully we can learn together. So how do we now analyze this case?
The audio is okay, but the screen is on, the PPT is on slide 1. I can see that only.
Okay, that's okay. I only put it on slide. But audio is okay, right?
Okay, yes, perfect.
Is the FB thing got hanged or something like that? Check.
No, it's working. FB, perfectly. Okay. I can see.
Perfect. So what to do? Let's see what to do. So what did I do? I want to tell you this. So what are the rubrics that I took? Okay. The first rubric. Okay, and this is where I want to tell you what is happening is most of you guys are focusing only on the mental state. And this is something that I learned from a lot of people, a lot of masters. That if you focus only on one thing, you will typically see only one side of the picture. So that's where you have to look at a remedy which has a mental state like this and also has a physical state like this. You have to take both together. So what did I do? Let's see. So let's see the first rubric I took. So first rubric, eruptions, crust, scabs, number one. Okay, next rubric, intolerable itching. She cannot even imagine the type of itching. So intolerable type of itching. Okay, so I have taken the first two rubrics as physical symptoms. Next, now I start looking at the state of mind. What is the thing about her state of mind? She's very loquacious, very loquacious. She's very communicative, expansive. She's very extroverted. Yeah, very extroverted. The way she talks, the way she is, she's very cheerful. So when you put all of these rubrics together, okay, what do you think will be the remedy that will be coming? So a lot of suggestions here. So we are going to learn something very, very interesting. Yes, one more very important rubric, I forgot this. Optimistic. So when you put all of these rubrics together, what remedy will come? One more, you can take her way of talking with a lot of enthusiasm, vivacious. Maybe the first rubric could be optimism. Okay, so we are going to see a very interesting remedy. Let's see. So the remedy that you're going to see here is we are going to talk about now the picture of a remedy which we normally don't think about. We are talking about Hydrocotyle Asiatica. And now what's important also that we know this about what is Hydrocotyle Asiatica. Let's have a look. So Hydrocotyle Asiatica, open Boric Materia Medica. As you know, it's called as the Indian Pennywort. And then you can open the skin symptoms and you can see it's a major, major remedy for any kind of dry eruptions which has great thickening of the epidermoid layer and a lot of exfoliation of scales, intolerable itching, in fact, everywhere, and also has a lot of profuse sweat like calcarea carb as well. So that's what we are going to learn. We are going to learn about a very lesser used remedy. And as Dr. Vijay Vaishnav used to tell us in our college days, rare remedies are rare remedies because they are used rarely. So I have to write this statement of his that opened it up for me. Rare remedies are rarely used. I gave Hydrocotyle Asiatica. So we have given 200 potency and we have given one dose every 15 days. And there was a remarkable change after giving Hydrocotyle Asiatica. In fact, within 2 months, the eruption and scale reduced, the itching reduced by 25% in the first 2 months. And remember, this is a remedy which has been given before this. Many remedies have been given, so that's why we had to think out of box. And at the end of a year, there was a remarkable change. The skin totally cleaned up. You know, I was giving a dose every 15 days, almost for a year. Remarkable, remarkable change. So this is what we are going to learn today. We are going to learn about this lesser known remedy, a little bit out of box remedy. And that's what I want you to know, learn, that not always you will see calcarea, phosphorus, silica helping. Sometimes you have to think a little out of box. So welcome to Materia Medica series day 19. And welcome to learning the remedy Hydrocotyle Asiatica, the Indian pennywort, which belongs to the plant kingdom. Indian pennywort or Hydrocotyle Asiatica, interestingly, a lot of things have been spoken about this remedy, and it is native to India, Sri Lanka, Australia as well. And it is known in different terminologies. Centena Asiatica, it's also known as. Interestingly, the way I have understood Materia Medica, and I believe what is today's times we need to understand Materia Medica is by understanding in different levels, understanding the toxicology, understanding what it is used in modern medicine for, understanding the not just the Materia Medica keynotes, repertory, rubrics, but trying to understand it from all different levels. So toxicology, this herb works by averting a disorderly manner of absorption of nutrition, and it has properties of antibacterial, antiviral, and anti-inflammatory as well. Interestingly, nowadays a lot of research shows a lot of maintaining youth and treatment of arthritis known for Hydrocotyle Asiatica. So interesting. CNS has also showed a lot of interest, and that's what I'm going to talk about as well. One of my other teacher, who Dr. Vijay Vaishnav actually referred me to, often taught that Hydrocotyle Asiatica can be used especially in neurological problem, especially post-stroke. So Dr. Sarkar uses Hydrocotyle Asiatica post-stroke when there is a lot of dullness and mental weakness, interestingly. So this is what is about it more or less. Now let's try to understand the remedy Hydrocotyle Asiatica in as much importance. So this I am reading from Pierce, Plain Talks on Materia Medica, an amazing book where actually it is the only Materia Medica book. I think I'll just show you very quickly this book, Pierce, Plain Talks. Willard Pierce, Plain Talks on Materia Medica. This is a book very important today's times to really understand clinical Materia Medica and Hydrocotyle Asiatica. Beautifully, he's explained Hydrocotyle. Hydro means water, cotyle means cavity, and that's how the plant looks actually. So fantastic book to a real clinical understanding of Materia Medica, Hydrocotyle Asiatica, here given by Pierce, Materia Medica. So now let's try to read Allen's Provings. Let's go to Provings and try to understand this remedy. Allen's, let's read Encyclopedia. And let's have a look. In Allen's Provings, one of the main symptoms is you can see gaiety, loquacity, unreserved communicative disposition, confidence in the future. So this is very interesting of Hydrocotyle Asiatica. And there's another stage also of Hydrocotyle. This is much later when they are really, really shaken up, when there's a huge impact or there's a huge kind of disappointment in their life, they become very gloomy. There's an inclination for solitude. There is a misanthropy. And this misanthropy is a very, very important symptom in another stage of Hydrocotyle Asiatica. Also, if you read the Provings, there's a lot of symptoms of depression, heaviness, lassitude, great weariness, and ennui. Excessive heaviness and dullness and unfitness for doing anything. But if you want to really know the use of it and what I've learned it from a lot of my teachers, including Dr. Vijay Vaishnav and Dr. Sarkar, is in excessive thickening and exfoliation of epidermis, even in cases of psoriasis, even in cases of elephantiasis, but psoriasis, especially in the trunk and especially in the palms and soles. You should think about this remedy. One of the very important thing also is, like I told you, psoriasis, malnutrition, lot of sweat. And that's why I want to tell you, Hydrocotyle Asiatica will often look like calcarea carb due to a lot of sweat. It's also clinically known for one of the most important thing is in chronic cases of skin pathology with a lot of scales, when indicated remedy doesn't work. Think about this remedy that time. Pathologically, it's very important for intestinal inflammation and cellular proliferation as well. It's a clinical specific for scleroderma, as well, and it has been proved by a famous Bengali physician, Ramada Prasanna Biswas from Pabna, and he has spoken about how clinically hydrocodone asiatica has cured very, very difficult lupus conditions. In very, very bad cases of chronic liver disease, also hydrocodone asiatica, clinically specific for vaginitis pruritus. In their repertory, there is a single remedy for vaginitis pruritus, that is hydrocodone asiatica. Robert's repertory, Robert's sensation as if. Very interesting repertory as well. It's a repertory I would highly recommend for people who use a lot of sensation method. It's a very interesting repertory and I use it very often. Very few people on the planet use this repertory. The main rubrics that Robert's sensation as if gives, marrow of bones as if hot water ran through it, which makes it a very interesting remedy for rheumatoid arthritis and even for bone metastasis from cervical cancers. There are a lot of fears like calcarea carb. Typically, hydrocodone will have a lot of fears of calcarea carb. Why? Because hydrocodone asiatica belongs to umbelliferae family, which is the same family of conium, which is the same family of ethusa, which is the same family of cicuta. And the main theme of these remedies are there is a lot of jerks and spasm in this remedy, but the main theme is sudden unexpected violence and attack. And if you remember our case, there was a lot of anything suddenly coming in front of her. So this kind of sudden unexpected attack, anything suddenly coming and just jarring her, is a very important theme of not just of the umbelliferae family, but also of hydrocodone asiatica, which is very interesting. Let's go a little ahead. Especially it has also helped. So there's another very interesting remedy, interesting book that I think you should know. Norton ophthalmic disease, very important. It's one of the only books on ophthalmic pathology and is written hydrocodone has especially helped many epitheliomas and tumors of the eyelids, like chronic chalazions. You can think about hydrocodone as well as another remedy, platanus. Maybe someday I will talk to you about platanus as well. It's known as a clinical specific for elephantiasis. Most homeopaths use this in a low potency. There is a lot of action of hydrocodone asiatica on cellular proliferation, and that's why very important for benign as well as malignancies. There's a profuse sweat like calcarea carb. So you can see very interesting presentation. PPT. This is held by my team, Dr. Juhi Malhotra. So if you like my presentation, do not even say anything to me. You have to really encourage my team, Dr. Juhi Malhotra, for this. We had Dr. Daksha Vaishnav yesterday and her talk was so interesting. And she would also swear by this, that this is a very important remedy in ulceration of the womb and in pains of cervical cancer. Difficulty in maintaining upright posture in the back as well. Sarkar Sir specific, he uses this for brain strengthening. He calls hydrocodone asiatica as the brain strengthening remedy, and any kind of post-stroke he uses this because he has seen hydrocodone asiatica in 6 potency. It induces the whole area of the brain which causes talking and hearing. So this is clinical homeopathy as well. Intense itching accompanied by redness and perspiration. Psoriasis, like I told you, when it begins from palms and soles. Blackwood Materia Medica, very, very interesting. Alexander Blackwood Materia Medica, who talks a lot about pathophysiology of homeopathy. It's also a very, very interesting book and I highly recommend it for a lot of our participants here. Blackwood's Manual of Materia Medica. This was also introduced to me by Dr. Vijay Vaishnav. It's indicated in cases of granular cervicitis where the cervix is red, associated with a lot of heat and itching of vagina, irritation of neck, and there is profuse leucorrhea as well. Like I told you, it belongs to the umbelliferae family. Let's see if we missed out on most of the symptoms. So hydrocodone asiatica, I told you, top remedy for interstitial inflammation, cellular proliferation. Action on leprosy in lupus where there is no ulceration. Ulceration hasn't started. Which is a remedy in cancer where ulcer has not started? Any idea? Let's see some of our participants. This remedy is very important for pains of cancer when ulcer has not started. Let's see. Mohsin is here, my friend. Maybe he can answer this. It's written in Boric, probably 6th or 7th line of this remedy. Hello?
Few suggestions from GoToWebinar participants.
Bolo.
R-Syod, anthraxinum.
Okay.
Asteria. Hydrastis, Collinsonia, opium.
अभी सब दवा बोलेंगे तो एक तो लगेगा ही ना. Anyways, if you tell all remedies, all khichdi together, one of them will work. Anyways, the very important remedy here is hydrastis, cancer and cancer state before ulceration when pain is the principal symptom. Very important indication of hydrastis. This is clinical materia medica, comparisons of remedy. Let's come back to hydrocortile. Also very important for pruritus of vagina, we told ulceration of the womb. Leucorrhea, profuse leucorrhea, lot of pain in ovarian region as well. Skin pathologies, typically known for skin pathologies. Syphilitic miasm, elephantiasis, lupus, leprosy, acne, difficult acne, circular spot skin pathology, pustules, psoriasis typically in trunk, and lot of layers and scales coming out. Very important for pain in left cheekbone as well. And it's been compared to LS, very important remedy for scleroderma. Hoorah, top remedy for also for leprosy and more. Huanan, also Loganaceae family, also for leprosy and so on. So this is a little bit, I wanted to give a little out of box kind of remedy today. And I also wanted to tell you this picture which I have seen in few cases, and this case of skin pathology totally reversed with hydrocortile. So I want you guys to see this, not just listen to me blindly, apply it. I want you to apply it totally and tell me what do you think about hydrocortile asiatica with this kind of story of hydrocortile asiatica. Write to me, this is my email ID, about what you learned about hydrocortile asiatica today. And as you know about my books, Decoding Mental Rubrics and Sarcoidosis, I hope you're reading it. And also my new book on different repertories I'm working on. And I hope you get a chance to read about it soon. I'm also writing two more books. Hopefully, God willing, it will be out. So write to me what you feel about it. And I think this is the right time to invite my mentor and my teacher, Dr. Vijay Vaishnav, online. And a lot of participants are actually waiting to hear him.